My name is Ira Starks, and I'm from Rochester, New York, born and raised here. I had lymphoma cancer.
My name is Paul Barr. I'm an oncologist, hematologist here at the Wilmot Cancer Institute. I'm a lymphoma investigator and also medical director of the clinical trials office here. There's multiple purposes for clinical trials. And in many clinical trials, that's determining if a drug, a treatment, a device is safe and effective. But often when I'm discussing a potential clinical trial with a patient, I remind them that the main purpose of our relationship, of my taking care of them, is to give them the best possible care.
When Dr. Barr and I talked about the clinical trial, we were focused on how my participation could help benefit my recovery and prevent the cancer from returning. It was clear that not only could this help me, the data that could be collected could most likely help someone else.
There are many situations where newer targeted therapies look much more promising than some of the, say, older chemotherapeutic options. And when the preliminary data suggests that patients may derive significant benefit and avoid significant toxicity, often I will recommend a clinical trial in that situation.
I felt a little uneasy at first when Dr. Barr recommended the clinical trial, but after he thoroughly explained what I could expect from it and what the goal would be, is that we want to try to prevent the reoccurrence of the cancer. That helped me understand and made me feel a lot more comfortable.
I think it's natural for patients to have some skepticism. Typically, when we talk through the pros and cons, the potential benefits, the potential risks, it mostly eases patients' minds to understand this is just one more treatment option for them to consider. Clinical trials go through many layers of review. They need to be conducted in a safe, ethical, and compliant manner. They are reviewed at the investigator, the physician level, but also by regulatory authorities, institutional review boards, to ensure that not only is it ethical, but it's going to benefit patients.
I personally have had a good experience with the medical community, from a young child to an adult, but I understand others may not have had the same experience I've had. What I would recommend for anyone that have possibly a trust issue with the medical community, please talk to your physician or nurse, someone from the medical community, because they're going to be able to answer your questions. And the key would be is not to be afraid to tell them how you feel. Dr. Barr made me feel comfortable, and I could feel that this is the right thing for me. It made sense.
Clinical trials are undoubtedly advancing the science of caring for cancer patients. In just the time that I've been practicing, I've seen clinical trials completely reshape how we take care of patients for the better. We now have treatments that have less side effects, are more targeted towards the therapy, are providing better outcomes.
My experience with the Wilmot Cancer Center has been incredible. The folks here supported me. You can feel that there was concern about me as a person, not just another patient. I feel strongly that the clinical trial is the reason why I'm at this point in time cancer-free.